Sobat School Fans, dan kita balik lagi di acara Pick Up Game bersama members. Ini udah volume ke-14, gila gak berasa sih, udah 14 kali kita main basket bareng. Gue enjoy banget selalu kalau bisa ketemu dan juga ngumpul bareng dengan para members gue dan juga main basket. Vibesnya selalu asik dan juga banyak gosip kita di sini. Dan pasti ntar kalau udah mulai main pasti agak kompetitif juga ya. Jadi kalau kalian bulan depan ingin ikutan bulan April untuk main Pick Up Game dengan members dan juga Time Out Gang, pastikan kalian daftar juga join jadi member, lalu masuk ke Discord Time Out Gang. Nanti kita akan kasih informasi tanggal dan juga jamnya serta tempatnya untuk Pick Up Game berikutnya. Dan hari ini like always pastinya ada guest star. Hari ini ada Ivan dan juga ada Sena dari Create Leads. Gue penasaran sih, Ivan main abis dari Jepang, dia tuh kayak banyak meetings. Jadi gue mau nanya sih, dia ngapain aja dan juga kira-kira ada opportunity apa untuk pemain muda kita ke depannya di B-League. Jadi ditunggu aja untuk interviewnya. Ya, selain itu, kita udah gak sabar sih untuk main. And yeah, once again gue mau say thank you kepada semua members gue yang sudah meluangkan waktunya hari ini, macet-macetan dan juga hujan-hujanan guys. Gila sih, hujannya gede banget hari ini. Dan gue agak lupa kalau hari ini adalah long weekend, tapi mereka tetap berbaik hati dan juga meluangkan waktunya. So I really appreciate them. And once again, thank you guys for watching. And now it's time to play ball, guys.
Oh! Yes, apa itu?
Coach, boleh coach. Wah, enggak masuk-masuk halnya, bagus padahal. Wah, ini datang-datang bawa apa nih?
Datang-datang
ada oleh-oleh. Wah, Kobe Silver. Oh my god.
That's for you, my guy.
Thank you banget. Dalam acara apa gue dikasih? Baik banget sih.
Dalam acara gue baik aja.
Thank you ya.
Gila. You're welcome.
Dari Adidas Indonesia nih. Thank you so much, man. Appreciate you.
You're welcome.
Come support, you know what I mean? Everybody come support the IBL, so I want to come support the community, come see the hoopers and stuff like that. Also, a lot of you fans, when the games go to IBL, y'all always think y'all know what we should do. So now I'm here to scream and yell at them when they do something dumb. Alright, so.
Alright, so you're gonna coach?
Yeah. I'm coach, I'm gonna be a crazy fan. What? Why are you doing that? Don't shoot the ball! Get him out! I'm gonna be doing that today.
So you'll be at the reading all the comments on Instagram?
Yeah, you know, you gotta read them sometime.
I appreciate you though coming, stopping by here, you know.
Bro. As much as you do for us in the league and all
showing
the content.
Love.
Got you, bro.
Appreciate you, man. But how does it feel, man, coming back, man, to the Indonesia? Did you know that you're gonna get signed?
Nah, I didn't know that, not at all. I was out here just chilling, you know, chilling with my boy, and decided to stay a little bit longer, and after a while, conversations started happening. So I was like, all right, I'm staying a little bit longer, see what happens, and on your call. While I was actually working out, I was working out with Paul from Satya Muda. We were putting in some work together. I got the phone call, finished the workout, got my bag, went straight to practice after that.
I heard you staying at his house, at Ivan's house?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Did he give you a bag, or were you sleeping on the couch?
That's crazy.
I give him my room.
Oh! Yeah, I give him my room, the whole room.
That's
whole room.
Nice.
Nah, definitely, it was family love. It's, like I said, coming back here is not like I'm like visiting. It really feel like home, you know? See my boys, chill. I got people on different teams and things of that nature. So I don't really got to stay at no hotel if I don't want to, you know what I mean? Like, this is really home for me.
But we're happy to have you back, though. We need that energy, bro. We need that energy.
We're here, man. Y'all know the rules. How before you eat. Gang, gang, gang. Wolf gang, bird gang this year.
Man, we gotta talk, man. What's going on with your guy today, man?
What's happening? You gotta ask him. What's happening?
Bro, you gotta train him tomorrow, man.
Yeah, in the gym tomorrow, man.
I need some more workout, yeah.
Because, hey, uncle is, he told me he worked out 4 times today.
That's crazy. That's
4 times.
How do you have the energy?
Yeah. I can't imagine.
If I wanna keep up with the guys that's coming up, I gotta do more, you know?
Yeah, young players. Here, listen.
Listen to that. Listen to that.
You know what I mean? So when y'all when y'all working out two times a day, I'm working out four times a day. You know? So we get on that court, it's an even playing field. You dig?
Hey, but my boy, need to play better though.
Yeah, bro. Let's. Man, we gotta get right. You're in the gym with me tomorrow. That's a fact.
I got you.
7 a.m. tomorrow with Uncle Hakim.
My bad.
Noki. Mantap nih duo biru. Punya banyak shooter nih sekarang timeout, geng. Setelah sekian lama nggak ikut pick up game, Noki Noki makin jago nih. Di Mojokerto ngapain aja deh. Udah hapet ya semuanya. Wah gila bener-bener. Ternyata latihan terus deh, dia main di pick up game jago. Oke, Abu Zar. Sayang. Oh, nice pass. Nih, Noki Noki. Punya shooter banyak gitu sekarang emang. Oh, damn, big fella.
Lo latihan apa selama ngamen pick up game? Gue tambah jago.
Gak pernah latihan.
Masa? Gak mungkin. Kurus, kurus banget lo.
Gak pernah latihan.
Jago.
Tapi kalau boxman bisa lah, boxman. Kalau Oki coba dilihat kayak gak ada poin.
Kan highlightnya udah diedit.
Oh dia. Udah hilang semua ntar.
Ini saatnya untuk mengkorek-korek informasi. Kita bersama Ivan Manteng, gimana?
Ini banyak.
Udah selalu support datang komunitas gue.
Always.
I really appreciate you. Nah ini baru pulang dari Jepang, jadi gue pengen tahu. Jadi kemarin tuh ke Jepang ngapain aja, Van?
Oke, jadi gue berangkat ke sana sebenarnya emang ada sedikit ajakan lah dari beberapa tim yang pengen explore tentang slot Asian imports mereka gitu. Dan gue jujur juga one of my goal itu punya pemain-pemain gue tuh ya mereka biar punya experience di overseas. Di luar ya, my big goal is to have one Indonesian player to play in the NBA, Indonesian, right? Terus ya di sana, alhamdulillah kemarin dikenalin sama, thank you so much to Coach Cesar, asisten coachnya SM. Dia kenalin gue ke, namanya Coach David. Jadi Coach David ini, he's from Spain also. Dia kenal dekat sama Coach Manu, dia head coachnya Shiga Lakes, the Kiver Ravenna. Jadi sampai sana, ya Coach David cerita maksudnya se-organize apa dan semua-semua dia, even cara meeting, cara dia nanya pemain lu punya siapa aja, gue harus ketemu scouters, harus ketemu player manager, harus ketemu semua. It's not about like talking to head coach directly and then okay, I want him.
Jadi layernya banyak tuh ya?
Layernya banyak
yang harus dilalui tuh.
Dan kebetulan kemarin kesana juga Kreatlit ada tujuan signing sama the legendary Maxi Asho.
Okay.
He'll finish in May, maybe someone wants to...
May cocok tuh, sebelum karena playoff IBL masih akhir Juni kayaknya.
Awal Juli kayaknya.
Awal Juli mungkin yeah, malahan ya. Wow, jadi kemarinnya ketemu Maxi, how is Maxi though?
Maxi is doing great. Maxi is still Maxi, he's still killing right there.
They mean B3.
B3. Yeah, Saitama Broncos.
Okay.
Tapi di luar itu banyak banget experience yang maksud gue, okay, mungkin bilik di sana udah sangat mature dan dewasa dan lain-lain, cuman yang gue sangat appreciate dan gue pelajari di sana adalah culture-nya sih dok. Pertama yang gue temuin adalah pas gue nonton home game-nya Maxi di Saitama, pas gue sampai ngambil tiket dari Maxi, orangnya itu bilang, gue suruh copot sepatu dok.
Oh wow, jadi masuk ke lapangan sebelum nonton harus copot sepatu.
Harus copot sepatu.
Gue belum pernah denger tuh.
Unless lu pakai sepatu basket, terus lu harus ke traction mat-nya dulu, baru lu boleh masuk. Kalau enggak lu harus copot sepatu, dan orang Jepang di sana udah biasa masuk kayak sendal rumah apa sendal hotel.
Jadi nonton pakai sendal rumah semua dong.
Ada sepatunya diplastikin atau ditaruh rak di depan. Jadi ya itu salah satu cara mereka menghargai yang gue lihat.
That's interesting.
Yang kedua yang paling menarik menurut gue, setiap abis game mereka harus go around the arena say thank you to everybody. Like thank you, arigato, arigato.
Pemain,
head coach, semua berjajar jalan kelilingin. Dan semua orang Jepang udah tahu mereka gak boleh disentuh. Jadi pas mereka lagi muter, everyone is like, thank you. Mau kalah, mau menang, you have to do that.
Wow, that's interesting. Tapi kan lo main ke Jepang, ketemu dengan beberapa tim di B3 berarti ya?
B3, B2, B1.
Nah, gue paling penasaran, of course ya, kan kita udah ada Abraham tahun lalu kan main di Jepang. Kalau kayak gini, ada nggak sih mereka interest untuk mau ngambil pemain Indonesia lagi ke depannya gitu? Ada obrolan nggak sih tentang itu?
Justru itu yang membuat saya berangkat ke sana. Jadi ada salah satu tim dari B-League ini yang menyebut salah satu nama. Hey, it's really interesting.
Pemain lokal?
Pemain lokal.
Pemain lokal di Kreatlit?
Pemain lokal.
Oh, siapa tuh kira-kira ya? Jadi chance-nya berapa besar untuk pemain yang dari Creative sini pindah ke Jepang? Berapa besar chance-nya?
Ya, mungkin gue bisa bilang gue, I'm so confident, like 100% I will have like at least like 3 guys right there.
3 guys?
But maybe in 2026.
Oh, masih 2-3 tahun lagi.
Soalnya mereka tuh ternyata, kalau untuk sama pemain yang mereka lihat big potential, mereka bukan yang kayak, okay, I sign him directly. Tapi mereka udah keep the name dari sekarang, lihat perkembangannya, nonton. Even pas gue bawa nama si A ini, mereka udah langsung, yeah, I know him. Tapi field goal-nya begini. Kadang-kadang kenapa mainnya cuma segini? Ini kenapa begini? Ini kenapa begini? Berapa kali pergi malam setiap minggu?
Sampai segitu detailnya.
Weekend, kegiatannya apa, dan lain-lain. Karena ya di sana, Maxi bilang gila sih.
Strict banget ya?
Strict banget. Cuman ya, at least as long as you guys follow the rules, you will.
Ya iyalah, di sana bayarannya mahal sekali guys. Makanya harus disiplin dan harus strict. Tapi kita excited lah kalau lu ngomong 2-3 tahun lagi, obviously kita punya banyak pemain muda yang berbakat sih. Jadi yes, very excited sih untuk melihat gila pemain-pemain Indonesia yang muda bakal makin banyak yang overseas ya.
Terus ya, mereka juga nawarin walaupun mungkin belum langsung ke sign, tapi di off season they wanna train with them right there. Tinggal beli tiket pesawat, datang sana, dibayarin mes sama makan, latihan bareng.
Dibayarin makan sama mes? Oh, baterai udah mau habis. Oke, itu tadi cerita dari Ivan. Good luck ya. Kita sih doain Ivan sama kreatif lah. Biar bisa, you know, bikin basketball di Indonesia juga berkembang dan juga makin global ya.
Amin. It's all with the support. Dari support dari lu juga, Rok.
For the Indonesian basketball culture.
For Indonesian basketball culture.
So guys, itu aja kontennya hari ini dari Pick Up Basketball. Hopefully you guys enjoy it. And once again, thank you kepada Sena juga
thank
sepatunya.
Thank you.
Sepatunya, thank you Sen. Bentar sepatunya.
Gua ambil dulu.
Yeah bro. Dari Sena, ini sepatu gua SD sih.
Shout out to Adidas Indonesia and Foot Locker Indonesia.
Foot Locker Indonesia, Adidas Indonesia, I really appreciate you dan vote it. Kelihatan gak vote it deh. Vote it. So once again, thank you so much everybody for supporting, and we'll see you guys again next video. Peace out everybody.